Welcome to WebStylePress. Can a CSS file trigger 500 error? Can CSS file be the cause of internal server error? I'm using WordPress. Page that you are looking at is built with Elementor page builder. Right now, it is not displaying some images. Some images are being displayed and some are not, especially the backgrounds. And you know, first thing web developers do is to check console errors. That is first step in debugging. If I go to console, I see failed to load resource. The server responded with the status of 500 internal server error. In front of that, I see a CSS file post5.css. This file is triggering internal server error. And this post15.css file. If I click at this file, right click, open a new tab, and here is the internal server error. If we hover over this file name, we are able to see the file location. Uploads Elementor CSS. It's in the CSS folder, that is in Elementor folder, and that folder is in Uploads folder. It is CSS generated by Elementor, and it is in the Uploads folder. If we go to Uploads folder, we see Elementor here, and it's got CSS folder, and these are the CSS files. For some reason, Uploads folder is not able to display CSS files properly. It can be htaccess rules issue, any plugin conflict, or a plugin misconfiguration. To fix this error, we can deactivate all plugins and themes and check if the issue is resolved. This way, we can track down the misconfigured plugin. But there is another way. Elementor CSS file has issue. Let's check Elementor settings for CSS file. Go to Elementor settings. Go to Advanced tab. Look at CSS Print method. It is external file right now. Change it to internal embedding. Save changes. And if now we reload the page, problem solved. We removed Elementor's dependency on using CSS files and configured it to use CSS in head section of page. This is a quick fix for the issue, but you should really track down the actual cause of issue. It can be due to Uploads folder being used or processed by some mechanism that is not compatible with Elementor, or there is some plugin conflict, or it can be htaccess rules that you need to dig into to find real cause. But here you go. Change the way Elementor uses CSS and problem is solved. If I go to console now, there are no errors. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.